So today we're going to look at driver technology and what's changed, particularly in the last 20 years, and see if you're better off to just upgrade your driver, if it's pretty old, or whether the old club can still do the job. So today I'm going to look at my driver from 20 years ago. If you come in nice and close here, we'll have a look. On the right-hand side is my current gamer, Callaway Epic. And on the left-hand side is my old gamer from 20 years ago when I first turned pro, 983K. So I'll pick those up. You can see the size difference is massive. If we come up and have a look at the shafts, graphite design, wire 6. Really popular shaft this was in its day. I still get asked for it, actually. Really, really popular. So I'm going to see how that stacks up against my current gamer Power Surge by Fujikura. We have a look at these heads. Here's the 983K. 9.5 degrees. It's about D2.5 and 45 inches long. And then my current driver, Great Big Bertha Epic, 10.5 lofted down to 9.75, 45 and a quarter, and D3. So similar specs in the two drivers. Okay, so the big difference, I think, is in the head size. And so I think the current driver is going to be more forgiving. And I think it'll go further too. It's been sort of optimized for me, but it'll be interesting just to see if there is any differences, what those differences are in flight and spin and launch and whatnot. So I'm going to go and hit some shots and we'll take some results and have a look. Okay, so here's the results from the two drivers. The top driver is the Epic and the bottom driver is the 983. You can see the total distance is about 7 meters longer with the Epic. A little bit higher in the clubhead speed. I couldn't get the 983. I really struggled to get it to 100, actually. So I had to swing pretty hard to get it up to that sort of pace. And then, so the Epic had, you know, another 4 miles an hour ball speed, similar spin rates. If you have a look at, you know, similar launch angles, but the Epic just kept going up into the air a little bit better. And so 31 compared to 28 with the peak height, very similar. You know, I tried to hit up a little bit more on the 983 to get it to go up in the air, but it didn't really want to. But quite surprising results with only about 7 meters difference in distance. The interesting one is when we have a look at the grouping, and you can see in the brownie color, that's the Epic. It just seems to go the same distance. I mean, the standard deviation forward and backwards was 3 meters, so it didn't matter how I hit it. It just went the same distance. Now, admittedly, it was probably a little bit, according to this table here, a little bit wider than the 983. But, you know, it's just not penalised for mishitting it. Whereas you can see with the 983, it had a great grouping, really lovely grouping there. But 11 metres standard deviation back to front, and one that I mishit, you know, it's just penalised harshly. Now, the other little thing you notice is probably the longest with the 983 is about the shortest with the Epic. But the Epic, like I said, just goes about the same distance. So very, very interesting. I think the biggest innovation we can see here is the front to back. And what you'd get, you know, out of the latest drivers is that forgiveness. So when you do mishit a little bit, they just go, you know, pretty similar. So that's, I think that's the main thing I took out of today's test, is that front to back.
Okay, so should you upgrade? Yes, definitely. Upgrade the old girl, go out and get yourself a new driver. That forgiveness is so much better these days. So do yourself a favor and make the game easier, not harder. Thanks everyone for watching today's video. We've got some great videos coming up in the next few days. Make sure you click on subscribe so you can find out when our next videos are coming out. Thank you.